SmartSuite is pumping out new features at an amazing rate, but one of the biggest features, in my opinion, just flew in under the radar, and hardly anybody's even talking about it, but this is gonna change the way you see your data. I'm really excited to show off how you can actually have a table of information inside of your records in SmartSuite. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Now, we're going to be looking at a SmartSuite feature in this video, but if you really want to unlock the true power of no-code tools, you've got to understand no-code automation. No-code automation is going to do those things in the background for you that you do over and over again. All that copy-paste nonsense, it's going to be done for you so that you can focus on high-value stuff. I want to invite you to my free training so that you can understand and master the key fundamentals of automation. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration, and I will include links to that training wherever you found this video. All right, without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and I want to show you this amazing new feature. I'm talking about looking at your linked relationships between tables in SmartSuite in a brand new way. I'm really honestly excited about it. Let's hop on in. If you don't already have your own SmartSuite account, be sure to sign up using our link and you will be put on a free pro trial. And of course, go ahead and follow along with us as we go through this new feature. Now, before we dive in at a high level, I first have to zoom out and have a quick conversation about the fact that SmartSuite just went through a little bit of a renaming. So previously inside of SmartSuite, this thing was called a solution, and then these things were called applications. And I am very, very excited to announce that SmartSuite thought maybe applications was a little bit complicated of a term and also maybe not the best description of what's actually happening here. So we are going to be now calling these things tables, which is probably very much more aligned for most of us. And let's be honest, that's really what they are. They are a table or a data set of specific information inside of your solution. Now, I really like the term solution, so I'm glad that one's sticking around, but we are calling these things now tables. So I have two tables, contacts and appointments. And in fact, I showed in a previous series of videos how we could automate our appointment collection with Calendly and Make so that somebody signs up for a new appointment with us and we search, and if the contact exists, we find them, and if they don't exist, we create them, and then we create an appointment and link it back to that person. Well, here we are. You can see that I've got a bunch of these different consultations connected to this one person here, and I've grouped all of my appointments by my contacts, right? So this chunk of appointments right here, there's six of them, all belong to this one person. Well, what if I want to see that information back on the contact level? When I open up the record here, I can see all of the information that lives inside of this record. So right now we've got a description that is blank. The title only has one name. We've got who this is assigned to, which is no one, the status. A lot of these parts are unnecessary, but here's where things get interesting. Here inside of this link to appointments, we see a bunch of untitled records right now, and they're kind of just in card view. Like, we don't have a ton of information on them, not here nor there. Now, this is exactly where this new feature is becoming very powerful, but because I haven't used it extensively, I'm going to stumble through trying to set it up. So let's flip into the action menu and see if we can determine how this stuff shows up. By modifying our field settings, we have our display format choices here. And we can see that a new display has been added. So check this out. We've got currently what SmartSuite calls the compact display. There's also a simplified display, and then just your standard display, which is just a linked record, and an expanded display. But this is the one that you can't sleep on. And this is, like I'm saying, SmartSuite kind of released this feature and it wasn't to much fanfare. I don't even know if everybody knows it's here, but as soon as this was shown to me, I was absolutely blown away. So let's bring in table display. And here we have the option, of course, of allowing to link to multiple records. This has to do with our actual linked relationship. I don't want to mess with that. What I do want to mess with is actually showing which of the fields I want to see in this grid view. So remember, right now we're looking at our appointments. So I have an expanded view of my contact, which is linked to an appointment, and I'm bringing in the grid view of appointments. So instead of seeing six different appointments like this, I want to see them on an actual grid. Okay, well, here is the stuff that I want to see here on the right-hand side. I actually don't care about assigned to, auto number, description, due date. No, I don't care about this either. In fact, all of these can go. So I just click them out. But what I want is the stuff that's specific to the appointment. So maybe the date of the appointment or the status of the appointment and status for appointment. Sorry, I grabbed the wrong status. Status for appointment is the one I want. The UUID from Calendly. You get the idea. I'm bringing this information in from the appointment and I'm choosing what's going to show up on my grid view. So cool, right? I can also apply a sort. So maybe I want to put these in an order. So I'll take my date field here. Start date is actually what we called it. And I'll put them in chronological order. Once I'm happy with that, let's go ahead and say, yep, move on from here. And I want to make sure I grabbed the right date. Yes, start date. Okay, perfect. When I'm happy with this, update the field and check this out. I literally have a grid view right here inside of my record, right? And so I don't have a title for these, which is something I should work to fix. Let's actually flip out of this really quickly, go into our appointments, and I'm going to update a title here just by saying this is going to be auto-generated with the start date. So let's bring in the start date here, grab that, update the field, flip back to our contacts, and let's open this up again. Remember, this particular contact right here has six different appointments, and I see them all right here. I can drill into them individually, but I can also, let's back up, take a look at this. I can right here export each one of these. I can also X this out, which would effectively remove it from that link. So now I have only been linked to five appointments. There's so much I can do. I can link to more appointments, etc. I mean, this is the same thing as having a linked relationship. It's just the way that I'm displaying it here that is blowing my mind. I mean, the fact that we can come in and see this, the way that SmartSuite has given us so much more control over how we see an expanded view of our record, I think this is one of those features that really sets us above in terms of what's possible here. Now, what I would love to do is have inline editing. And you see that right now I have to actually drill into this record in order to update this. Like, what if I wanted to just change something right here? I don't see a place right now where I get inline editing. I'm looking again just to verify that I haven't skipped anything. I don't think it's here just yet, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's coming. So imagine this. Now I can create a dashboard with information about my contacts, and without ever necessarily adding any other views, I can simply allow people to open up the contact and inside of that to see all of the associated appointments with all of the relevant information for those appointments. None of the extra noise, just the stuff that they care about, all because of this amazing updated view. So, did you know about this before this video, or is this news to you? Has this changed your opinion about the value of SmartSuite? Let me know in the comments below. I'm very curious. And in the meantime, keep on building.